Good morning, Indian River High School, home of the Braves. We'd like to ask you all to please pause for a moment of silence. Thank you. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may now be seated. Stay tuned for your morning announcements. Braves are who we are. Rise is what we do.
Mr. Curtis Swain.
Crystal Lawrence.
Debbie Fry.
William Volkman.
Miss Lambert.
Craig Blackman.
Miss E.
Mr. Lawrence.
Marie Miguel.
Miss Sullivan.
Mr. Evans.
Megan Horn.
Miss Bedley Meyer.
Mr. Rowe.
Okay. What made you become a teacher?
I love children.
Because I want to make change.
My sister was a teacher and it looked really fun. And she was like, you should try teaching. And I was like, I don't know if I'm going to like that. And then I do.
To
help kids?
Probably started by when I was in high school. I had a really, really good PE teacher. He did a lot of stuff that I learned from him. I'm actually carrying it over to today. Really, that's because he influenced me in PE class. I had him in driver's ed too when I was in school as well, when I was in high school. But he really influenced me a lot to become a teacher.
It worked with my own children's schedule, and I love helping kids.
Such a great question. Thank you for asking that question. So I enjoy investing in young people to see them maximize their potential and to speak into their lives and to just help them be all they can be.
How did you become a teacher?
I love history.
I became a teacher because I think I can help kids. I was a substitute teacher for a long time and really felt like I could develop relationships and reach kids. So I really developed a passion for it.
I had amazing teachers in school, especially my drama and choir teachers, and I wanted to be that person for my students.
I love helping kids and teaching them how to do new things.
I really enjoyed working with kids, and for me the alternative was to work in a boring old museum with a history background, so this seemed like a lot more fun.
Why did you become a teacher?
Because I wanted a history degree, and I was like, how else can I force other people to listen to me talk about history?
Oh, geez. Well, I really like the content. I teach social studies and I teach English, so I really like that. And I like working with students.
Well, because I want something that kind of fit the best with my son's schedule, right? So prior military, now working in my second profession. So I enjoy teaching, having my summers off, spending summer vacations with my son. So it gives me an ideal schedule to fit with his.
And plus, we need our Social Security as we get older.
Plus, summer's off.
Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome to Julian's Entertainment segment. Now, you guys just knew I would be back for this rap beef. Now, I have my script right here because there is a lot to cover. See, the girls are fighting right now. There seems to be a little bit of a civil war in the rap community, including Kendrick Lamar, Future, Metro Boomin, and Rick Ross versus Drake and J. Cole. Now, who started all of this? It seems to have all stemmed from J. Cole having a line in First Person Shooter saying that J. Cole, Drake, and Kendrick were the big three of rap, but overall J. Cole was on top. To which Kendrick clapped back saying, forget the big three, it's just big me. And from the rockiness of this beef, teams started to form and others started to come to the defense of their respected teams. Since all of this has gone down, Metro Boomin and Future have made a whopping two whole albums titled We Don't Trust You and We Still Don't Trust You. And get this, J. Cole switched teams. So now it's what seems like a 20-v-1 against Mr. Aubrey Drake Graham. See, there's a leaked Drake response floating around that seems pretty promising, where he says, "Metro, shut up and make some drums." Metro is mute. See, there's so much more to this story, but I'm already going a little bit over time, so I will be back with the part 2 to this lovely rap.